we wanted to just say a couple of words, Matt and I, Chris Lorenzo, Kristen, and...
Chris Lorenzo!
Thank all of you for helping us celebrate the final Broadway performance of the 27th longest running show. Forever underestimated the cultural phenomenon, the global success story, Rock of Ages. You have 2,328 previous opportunities. Maybe your marketing just kicked in, maybe your experience is crazy. I got the feeling, based on the crowd reactions, that there's a few people who have seen the show before. Part of the family, and we have strived from the beginning to consider Rock of Ages a family, and particularly with our cast, we have always said the door is always open. We'd love to see you back. We'd love to have you come in and hang out. We'd love to just spend some time with you, and so that has fostered the family atmosphere at Rock of Ages that has been so successful for us, and tonight we put the call out to our alumni. An amazing final scene. It's a last chapter in Rock of Ages Broadway, and we have to recognize it's a last chapter in some ways for the Helen Hayes Theater. They're making some changes here. They've been a wonderful partner. We want to thank Jeff Hayes. We want to thank some of the people who are behind the scenes but that make things happen. We want to thank Roy Gabay and his team, Daniel Jr., Peter Murphy, Andy Tate, aka Situation Interactive, Leslie Papa and Whitney Holden Gore, who 6 years later are still laughing at every joke. I think I speak for everybody here, and particularly everybody on stage, when I say that we are better for having the opportunity to know Matty DiCarlo and Justin Strickland. The investors, the producers, all the people that made this happen, our general partners, Barry Habib, impossibly lovable stuff, Kaizen, Megan Silver, Greg Sutton. I want to thank Michael Cole for giving me the opportunity to be here. And we have to recognize in every producing team and in every team there's a leader. And for us, the leader has always been Mr. Matt Weaver. Driving the bus on the road to Rock. Sometimes I think it was like Fred Flintstone where he didn't have any gas and he was driving with his feet. It's his vision, it's his creativity, it's his impossible optimism that we all followed and we're grateful for. I now have the opportunity to introduce one of the most sought after choreographers on somebody who's a pleasure to work with, and I recommend you do not mess with them.
Yeah. I'm gonna keep this so quick because I know we all have a party we want to go to. I want to thank this audience because I have never experienced anything like that. It's almost criminal to work on. It's so fun, and I want to thank, you know, besides my amazing collaborators and friends and family, I want to thank the actors, because every person on this stage, we looked for them and we found us, and they're amazing. They're doing it 8 shows a week, and they're really special, and I care a lot about them, and I can't wait to see you guys do next.
We love you.
So thank you. Woo! And now, the fabulous, most amazing hair, my partner in crime, Kristen Haney, our director. Is more fun than opening. Who knew that closing was like the best thing that's ever happened?
I know
it sucks on such a fundamental level, but what's incredible here is all the people that Rock of Ages has touched. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, all of you who come up to me and tell me that Rock of Ages changed your life, and then all of the people up here who've changed my life and who Rock of Ages have changed their life. I mean, to have all of this love, the 60 people up here that have given so much and to feel their hearts is just outstanding. So just, my heart is exploding in like 10,000 shades of glitter. I have to really quick thank our designers. Jason Lyons. And like this sucker, Beowulf. I feel like when you came and gave the set, you gave the structure for how this show works. Thank you, and thank you, Joe, for everything that you've done. Great, Gail, that detail in the costume. Oh my God, it is sexy and Indians is alive. Still awesome to this day. Zach, your love and the projections is incredible. Peter Holinsky, this sound. The entire musical team, the band, everyone. Wig design, makeup, everyone. It has been an incredible family. I'm just so grateful to have gotten the chance to witness and be a part of a miracle, which I know that Rock of Ages is, and it's a miracle that uses jizz in the script, which I think is awesome. My God, it's awesome. Thank you to Matt Weaver, who is the dream winner, never stop believing. I've never been on a ride that had more ups and downs than this fucking crazy ride. And just thank you for calling one day and said, hey, what about 80s music? That call. That was a really good day when I got that call. Kelly Devine, thank you for being in this friend. To their dead, and I'm sorry about that. And then Mr. Chris Lorenzo.
Yeah!
I feel so, you changed my life, man.
Renzo.
Yeah.
I love you so much. You're so smart, and every time I have directed 15 productions of this show, and every time I do, I realize more and more how smart you are, and like the different nuances that keep revealing themselves to me in this show. I will never forget the first time I met you, and you said, "Will you call your producers right now and tell them I'm the guy for this job?" And you were, and you had it all inside of you at that very moment.
Yes. Yeah.
Process, I got to watch you meet your wife,
yeah.
Get married,
yeah.
And have a child.
Yeah.
And with that, I passed. Anything on your phone?
Hello. I was going to use the time to show everyone pictures. Good time, right?
Yeah.
Obviously. You look around this room, and the one defining experience is that everyone loves each other.
Amen.
And that's what the show was always supposed to be about. When I was living in LA and living off Subway Club cards, thinking I wanted to be famous. And then you realize real quick it's all bullshit. It doesn't matter. And shows close, and tomorrow we're gonna be out there. And it's but what matters is the people that you are with and the relationships you form and the love you find. Mm-hmm. And we all found a lot of love here, and we feel it from you, and there's a lot of supporters and the audience that have touched our lives, and we really have. So you can't be mad about a show closing when it does that, you know? When people find love. And I will take the opportunity in front of a room full of people to thank my wife, who.
Yeah!
Random Sunset Strip slut. And she did a great job. And I could tell right away I wanted to marry that slut. And I wanted that slut to have my baby. And so I impregnated that slut. And I watched that slut deliver. A much smaller slut. The best thing in my life. It's all fun and love, baby. Now I want to thank the man who I wouldn't have a wife, I wouldn't have a baby, I wouldn't have a house, I wouldn't have anything except a lot of Subway Club cards if it weren't for one of my dearest friends, Mr. Matt Weaver.
But before I do, I want to introduce somebody who was supposed to be our boss because he was a theater owner, but he turned out to be our friend. His name is Jeff Tick. Which was true, he would give us a break. Every time we could have folded and he could have sold the theater for a lot of money, he goes, what do we gotta do? Let's keep going. He gave us a break. So I never looked at you as a theater owner. You're our friend.
As a theater owner, is also the first baseman of the softball. Experience is not about the opening and the closing, it's all the friendships that have been made up here, the love that's in this building. And I can't tell you, I've been through hell and back, and the experience and the friendships and the love that I've made with producers who we would typically fight with, who we didn't fight at all, and the cast members that I love like it's my own family. This was a collaboration among everybody, and the love in this building and the energy in this building is just incredible. And we will be linked, meaning the Helen Hayes Theater and Rock of Ages, forever and ever.
Yeah.
He's over 100 years old, and he's been in my family for 35, 40 years. And there has never been a show like this that, first of all, I saw it 100 times. Every other show I've seen once or twice.
39 steps.
39 steps. A half. I love the information.
Good job.
That would be great. Changes that are going on here, and there's a possibility that this might not be called the Helen Hayes Theater going forward. But the one thing that I'm not a fan of that either, but the one thing that we can all cherish is that the last show in the Helen Hayes Theater was the best show on Broadway.
More, then we'll go to the party. Can we close out my credit card? I comp the cast drinks. I'll do 2 minutes. And first off, how about this fucking cast? This cast. I've been in the cast since off Broadway. Paul Scheffler. So we're going technical, yes, 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 he started on Broadway, right? On Broadway, never missed it, never took a hiatus, Andre Ward, come on. Where's Tiffany?
She's
here. Or Justin. They cast the best fucking off-Broadway cast in history. And she told us, well, where's Tiffany? Or Justin?
Right here. Right
here. And they told us one day that Constantine Maroulis was coming in. And I think we both had the same kind of thing, because he was like, what? And we were like, what? And we both had the same opinion of each other, but this fucking guy made the show, his passion.
Spread that out for me.
Seriously, we wouldn't have made it without Constantine Maroulis. We thank you. Love your passion.
How am I feeling? Feeling good? Feeling pretty good?
Woo! Well, guys,
mean, this show has definitely changed my life, you know. Friends, family, literally family. Angel Reed, my partner. It's going to be really hard to top this one day, so, you know, hopefully you'll all support everyone else on the stage as much as you have tonight, and thank you for the opportunity. I love you guys.
There's our fucking band! Let's get the band! Come here, Joel! Tom, Angel, come here! Here's Trevor!
You better hope I don't get too much momentum going, but I just want to say that I'm a Broadway guy. These are rock guys. It's been an education for me in a very good way, and it's been the greatest experience ever, really. I can't. And Matt, you guys, thank you so much. I love you guys. It's a really fun show. And I've never rocked so much on the show. And that's what I really have to say. I've never been this hard in my life.
Seriously.
He's
tired.
Yeah. I will love this show forever. It did change my life.
Joel, Joel.
Yeah!
As much as I would love to recreate my famous Golden Mullet Awards speech for you this evening, I'm happy to report that I am a sober, lucid man this evening, and I just want to thank everybody really seriously for the support. It's been a magical ride. I love everybody that's been a part of the show, and it's really been a life changer for me, so thank you all for the support, and really I feel like I'm the most blessed guy with the best job in the world, so thank you very much.
Kristen and Chris and the cast and the band and Henry for putting up with our shit. We are a big pain in the ass to him. We call him Deuce on the way out, please. Alright, so anyway, thank you. Appreciate it.
Let's get to some what's up party. And you know, I want to give a shout out to actually all the other guys. All the stuff guys. Two more minutes of free drinks. All right. Where's Patty DiCarlo? Get your ass out here. Where's Justin Scribner? Where's Scribner? These are the unsung heroes. These are the guys that run the show. Come here. Honestly, this is not. I'm not trying to be funny. We love you. Thank you. These guys deserve a standing ovation. Thank you.
Career to the show, and I love you all. Thank you all so much. Don't stop believing.
I want to say a dirty word called general partners. I don't know if you guys know what that means, but it's the guys behind the show. And is that my kid? Seven or eight years ago, we were trying to raise the money for the show.
And it was all this. It was all fun, and it was great and warm and fuzzy, but you know, we were still called the Hudson Hawk of musicals from a reviewer in LA. And honestly, nobody was interested in the show. And the first guy, well, there were two guys that really started to take this to Broadway. It was Carl Levin. Carl put it on his fucking Amex card, and he greenlit this thing. And Carl believed in it. None of us knew Broadway. He said he did. And he started just charging and going and spending. And we definitely, we would not be here without Carl Levin. It's 100% the truth. We would not be here without Carl. And then I met Prizan, who was like, dude, we can do this 100,000 at a time. Like, if we just get on a plane, we'll go around the country and raise money. And Scott Prizan, I swear to fucking God, we wouldn't be here without Scott. Where is he? Where is he? Where's Scott Prizan? Get up here. Scott Prizan raised all the money for the show. He never stopped bleeding. Didn't quite know the numbers, but that was okay. But I'm not even joking. We would not be here without Scott and Carl. And this was 2008. The world was falling apart. Nobody could raise money, and nobody wanted to invest in this show, honestly. And no typical Broadway investors would give us money. I'm not even trying to make a joke. And it was Carl and Scott and Barry fucking Habib, this fucking maniac. By the way, Barry Habib wrote a seven-figure check in 2008 to get this show up. Is closing down to raise money for the show, right? Barry did it, Jeff Davis did it, Paula Davis did it, the Bergsons did it, Chuck Rolachek. I'm not even kidding. All these people, we had no recoupment chart, we had no data that showed it could work. These people were just moved by the show, and thank you. Thank you. Anybody who's an investor in the show, thank you tonight. We appreciate it. Headlining at the Pulse Neck Inn is the Rock of Ages fan. We heard. Can I promote that? All right. The Pulse Neck Inn. But thank you guys. We appreciate it. We want to thank our general manager, Roy Gavet, Deirdre, Daniel, Chris, Mandy, everybody who worked for that. Our fucking great. We do these marketing meetings every 2 weeks. We have no money to market. Like every week, there's 20 grand to market. Situation, aka Len Gill.
Janet!
It's unbelievable. We're getting to them. We're getting to them. We're getting to them. And we started 6 years ago. Ooh. We're going to thank Barry and Ethan? No, all right, Barry. No. I said this earlier, Leslie Papa, where are you? Yes! Vivacity, if you're a producer in this town with money, hire Leslie right now. I'm telling you, she's fucking loyal, she's the best. Leslie Papa, really, she's the best. Len Gill, we want to thank Local One. We fucking are pro-union here. We love the unions here. We want to thank the wardrobe department as well.
Wardrobe is very shy.
And Tiffany Molly, who does hair, and Renee Kelly, our supervisor
of hair. Alright, we're almost done. Quickly, there's two girls that the more the work they did, the less back end they got. Janet Billing and Hillary Weaver. We wouldn't be here without Hillary. If Hillary hadn't met Kristen, they were smoking cigarettes in the back alley at the Hudson, and they cooked up this idea, would not be here. Janet Billig, where's Janet? Google her. Thank you, Janet, we appreciate it.
Kaufman.
Gabe Kaufman wrote a check for $7 million to finance this show. Thank you. And he's got more money.
go.
That's it. I'm being silly now. But thank you, everybody. Thank you to the cast. Fucking Frankie Grande came in. Thank you, everybody. Jonathan Linden came into the show about 3 years ago, and everyone thought he was a snarky Canadian, but he was more than that. And I thank you for, the truth is we wouldn't be open without you. So thank you for bringing a business sense, a business mind, responsibility into the show. True, we wouldn't be open without you. Who did we miss? Anybody? No? Okay, the last thing is, I promise I wouldn't make fun of the movie. Got an interruption. Chris Torrenzo, will you come out here for one sec? Yeah. We've been on the show before, but everyone's talking about, and by the way, first off, we appreciate the super fans, Abe Kalamak. How many shows has Abe been to tonight? 527. Wanda, Abe, God bless, Chris Gates, we love her, we're thinking about her tonight. Thank you to Chris Gates. All this wouldn't happen without this nerdy guy who sat in his apartment in Sherman Oaks a few years ago, no, seriously, and wrote this show. California nerdy. Yeah, kind of cool nerdy. And we thank you, we love you, we appreciate you. And that's it. Thank you. Love you.
Living free! Receive the gym and the world!
cake my friends made too, so you have to take a picture.